I was at the Midland Game Fair on Saturday, where I met Davy Thomas, Cy Pittaway from Film and Lenses TV, Nigel Allen, editor of Airgun Shooter, Keith Anderson and Steve Wilde from Team Wild, Malc Barnard from Country Pursuits TV, and Airgun USA, Ted. And I was on the day stage stand, where I saw Davy and Cy talking to Ted, and I got into a conversation with them, and they asked me if I had any videos on YouTube. I didn't, so I asked them like what I should do. So they told me just to basically say what my rifle is and my setup. So that's what I'm gonna do. So my rifle is a Arms TX200 Hunter Carbine in Beech 2.2. On top I've got a Nikko Stirling Gamking 4-16x50, really nice scope, milldot, which is useful in wind and long range shooting. That's mounted on by a sport match mount. This costs £35. It's a one piece mount, as you can see. This holds the scope on firm. I mean, it is solid on there. I've taken this everywhere and it's lost at zero by a couple of millimetres, really. Nothing too major. It's a lovely rifle. It's an underlever spring cocket with the cocking arm. It's got an anti-bear trap device in it, which stops your fingers being taken off when you're loading the rifle. This bear trap does make a bit of a click as you're cocking it. Once you have cocked it, you must keep hold of this arm, otherwise as you load in, if both the mainspring and the anti-bear trap fail, it's not likely, but if it does fail, then it'll take your fingers off. But if you've just got a firm grip on this cocking arm, then that won't happen. You'll have a firm hold on it. So you load in that port there, the 2.2 pellet. The pellet is Airarms Diablo Field 5.52. Really nice pellet. Shoots out of this gun exceptionally well. Best pellet I've used. I've used the Vermin Hunter, not the Vermin Pels. I've used Accu Pels, RWS Superfield, RWS Superpoint, and the Airarms just shoot it amazingly. I've shot the Airarms fields out of this rifle at 55 yards and got 1-inch groups, 5-shot 1-inch groups, which is pretty immense for a spring 2.2 rifle. I haven't taken this in any competitions yet. I hope to do some HFT. Take it down on the HFT range, get my ranges sorted so I know where to aim for the different yards. The safety catch, the one thing I would say that I don't really like about this rifle is once you've cocked it, the safety catch pops on automatically. If you then, you're ready to take the shot, you disengage the safety catch and say the rabbit runs off. You cannot then re-engage the safety catch. You have to re-cock the rifle to then re-engage the safety catch. This is a bit naff, really. You should just be able to pop it straight off, but you can't. But you can de-cock the rifle just by pulling it in all the way, knocking the safety catch off, and squeezing the trigger at the same time, and then that's now de-cocked, only held on by the anti-bear trap device. Then you pull it a little bit, which releases it. That's now completely decocked. I've got a Airarms, I think it's a TX85 Moderator. That just screws on the end there. It does make the rifle a lot longer and a lot heavier, but for the sound, it's really worth it. Really is. You can see it makes it a fair bit longer. The rifle is now front heavy, but I can put up with that. So now I'll do a close-up of the rifle. The rubber ventilated butt plate, butt pad. This is really nice and soft. You can take this off and put a Rowan Engineering butt plate on. If you go on the Vermin Hunters TV channel, you can see Davy putting one of those butt pads on his TX200. The cheek piece. He turned it over. Nice sort of rollover cheek piece. Really nice. There's the fish scale checkering and the rosewood cap. Fully adjustable trigger. Crisp break. Safety catch. That one piece mount and the 4-16 scope. The fore end checkering. This gives you a lot of grip on the rifle. That's the anti-bear trap device, which that's what clatters when you cock it. To prevent that, you just push that down when you're cocking it. And then cocking arm and silencer. Beautiful rifle. We'll do it all, everything on our own. We don't need anything or if I lay here, if I just lay here, would you like?